Hello everyone and welcome to Minecraft Modding. First of all, I want to thank you for the 5 likes. That means a lot to me. And now let's explain the code that we've done in the last tutorial. So let's get started. And the first thing we did was we created a new file, blockhouse.java, and the code that was in that file was this one that is appearing on the screen right now. And now I will explain this code for you to understand better. So the package net.minecraft.source, the package has multiple uses. It can be used for permission, but for now let's just think it's where the files are located. The files are located under net/minecraft/source, so let's just think of that right now. Now the other thing we write in the blockhouse.java was public class house extends block. Well, public, it's used for permissions. You can use public, protected, private. Those are used for permissions. As the class, we can think of the class as a collection of all the code, and the block house is the name we are giving to the class. That means when we want to identify that class, we just write block house and the Java will come to this function, to this class I mean, and execute this code. Now the extends, it's like copying everything in that class and paste it under the block that is the class that's being extended. I hope you guys understand. If you don't, just post in the comments and I try to explain better. Now another thing we write is public house int I int j. The int I and int j are the inputs. For now let's not worry about them. We will use it for access later on in another tutorial. So the last line of code we write was super brackets I, j and the material. When we are referring to super, that means we are calling a super class and we are giving them three variables, is the I, the j and the type of material. In my case was wood. Well, the second file we edit was block.java. And the first thing we write on that was public static final block house. And this is a variable declaration. We are declaring a variable with the name house. So the second thing we write on the block.java was new block house 120.63. The 120 is the ID of the block. As I'd said in the tutorial, this number must be unique, no other block must have this number, and the 63 is the number that you get on the texture.png. I have here an image that illustrates that very well, the numbers. Now we edit as well the craftingmanager.java, and what we write there was recipe, add recipe, brackets, new item stack, brackets, block house, 5, new object. Well, block.house is the block, the type of the block you will get. In our case was the block we created, the block.house. And the 5 is the number of blocks you will get. If you, in this case you will get 5. If you place, if you insert there like 3, you will get 3 blocks and so on, and you understand that part. Well, following that we write this code that's on the screen right now, and that is, imagine that is your crafting bench. Well, as I said, the first row and the second row are all filled in like here, and the third row is only the first and the last one that's filled with some type of material. And you can change this to whatever you like. For example, the pickaxe is this one, and this one. Well, for now, my house is built like this, the block, and as you can see there. Now, character value of that block planks. It is the type of the block that you would need to place to craft your block. In my case, with planks, it can be sand, it can be dirt, stone, whatever. I think you get it. So, yeah, guys, the code was all explained. I hope you guys understand it. If you need some help, you can send me an email. The email will be in the description. So as the code and everything is in the description, you can download it, of course. And this is all for now. Thanks for the 5 likes again, and I hope you guys enjoy it, and peace out, guys.